Greetings, my people of Earth, and those above who are observing this. Breaking news. Breaking news, my people. But before I tell you how the breaking news is, right, go get your popcorn. Get your liquor of choice. Get your ganja. Whatever make you high. Whatever make you relax. Get it. Okay? And those of you who can't, sit still, buckle on your seatbelt, because I'm about to take care of now. Wild ride. People, what did I tell you all on March 10th in the video I uploaded? Didn't I tell you all the next Pope gonna represent Pope Set? Haven't I been telling you all about Pope Set and Pope Apophis? People, I'm about to prove to you all, prophecy people, and people, the truth is an offense, but it's not a sin. So those of you who want to criticize me, go with that knowledge. The truth is an offense, but it is not a sin. Okay? I'm going to prove to you all people that this new Pope here, he did not take his name off of Francis of Assisi. I'm going to prove it to you all people. I'm going to prove to you all that he is not the first Pope to take on the name Francis. Okay? I'm going to prove to you all that this guy is a Freemason. That he studied alchemy. That he studied how to control you all. He studied how to use the elements to control your people's mind, to move the masses. Because Pope Benedict was weak. He was weak. He didn't know nothing about that stuff. Okay? So I was able to run circles around him. So they brought in a new Pope, one who knows alchemy. Okay, he been studying people. I will prove it to you guys that this guy's a Freemason. Okay, he know alchemy. I'ma prove to you all the connection between his name and the first Pope Francis' name. Okay, he's Pope Francis II. This guy right here is Pope Francis II. Not the first, the second. And I'll prove to you all his name. Okay, Jorge Maria Mario. I'll prove to you all the connection with that name. To the first Pope back in the 1700s, okay? I'm gonna prove to you all that what CNN have told you all about him is a lie. Okay, people, I'm gonna prove to you all this guy, I'm gonna show you all his lifestyle and his upbringing and his following is not Francis of Assisi. It is Pope Francis I, the Holy Emperor and Pope of Rome, Italy. Okay, so bear with me. Buckle your seatbelt. Light up your spliff. Open your can. Take off that cap. And here we go. I'm gonna take you on a wild ride. Now, people. This video is in connection. Let me give you all a little preview. On March 10th, right? I upload this video, right? It's called Breaking News. The darkest detail of the Vatican best secret. Ushering in Pope Set and Christ 2013. Okay? And people, I'm going to prove to you all that this Pope, this new Pope, Pope Francis, represents Set. And what does Set represent, people? Murder of his brother Arthur, the netter of storm and violence. Set could use his destructive powers for good or evil, and was a counterbalance in an orderly universe. Symbolized destruction, confusion, and chaos. Now, people, for this Pope to represent Set, he have to know alchemy, right? He have to know how to move the elements. And who on earth right now really know alchemy and who keeping the secret from the rest of the world? The Illuminati, right? The Freemasons, right? The inner core of the Masons, not the outer ones who think that they have position. The inner ones, you know, the inner chamber. They know alchemy, right? They know how to use the elements. That's why they have those stone needles, those penises in front of their buildings, in front of the Vatican, Buckingham Palace, out there in London, in Washington DC, China all over the world. These male penises they have sticking in the air. Okay? Because they have power. Okay, in them. So they know alchemy. So this new pope now, he knows alchemy because he represents Set. I'm gonna prove it to you guys. In this video, people, I basically tell you all about me using my powers, which is basically alchemy, to fight against the Roman demons, right? And I told you all about homosexuality in the Vatican and all that stuff, right? And I told you all basically that Pope Set is going to be the next pope. And my friend here, Ethiopian.net, did a respond to my video, right? They did a response to my video. It's called Papacy Set Mythology and Satan Counterfeit Son Set. Who's your father? Right? And in this video, he basically did a follow-up on my video and he explained more about Set. So I recommend that you all, excuse me, we recommend that you all watch it, right? And he explained more about Set and Set role. Okay? So those of you who seek knowledge, I suggest that you watch it because it have a lot to do with this new pope that's about to control you all with his magical powers and put more homosexuality in the Vatican and in the world, make it more acceptable. Okay? So watch these two videos and increase your knowledge. But before I go to the other stuff, let me say one thing. Respect to my friend EthiopianWorld.net. When I first came on YouTube in 2008, they were my first friends. They were the one who was uplifting me, pushing me, encouraging me. But we had a kind of difference of opinions. So we kind of went apart. And it hurt me that we went apart because I really treasured their input. But my Lord told me, he said, leave him alone. He said, just you build it and they will come. Because basically you all believe in the same thing, but you are going to arrive at the truth at different path, but you're going to come to the same conclusion. So he said, just build it. Build the foundation and they will come. Because they're the one who's going to push your message like in the way that you cannot, because in America you are in bondage. Your videos are being blocked, your views are being withheld, so a lot of people are not being able to see your videos, so they will be able to help you push your videos. So just build it and they will come. So my brothers, welcome. Rara was right. They told me you will come because we'll both arrive to the truth, but at different path. So now we have reached that juncture. So people, I suggest you watch this video and you'll get what the significance of what I'm about to say. Okay? So here we go. Now people first, right? I'm gonna show you all what CNN have to say about this new pope, right? Then I'm going to disprove it. Listen how CNN is trying to fool you all. And when y'all don't do your own research, that's how y'all are easily misled. Okay, don't believe everything the media tell y'all about people. Do your own research. I just did. And I was shocked at what I found out. I wasn't shocked. Actually, I was vindicated. I was vindicated in what I found. So do your own research. Listen what CNN say about him, people.
The Diocese of Rome, he referred to that. The pastor came to meet his people, and it was beautiful. Then he took the microphone again, and he didn't follow the book. Thank God. Once in a while,
maybe
we need
that. Maybe
that's
a good thing right now.
Once in a while, we need that.
Can you tell me, what was your first reaction to the name? When you heard that he had taken the name Pope Francis,
what first went through your mind?
Everything. Francis of Assisi and this Pope, they're kindred spirits. Francis of Assisi is the patron of Italy and the universal saint and someone who reached out between all kinds of lines and divisions. Someone who turned his back on the wealth of his family and the lifestyle he had and bonded with lepers and the poor. And here's this Pope who's known for his care for AIDS patients and people who are very sick, who's known for his concern with single mothers whose babies were refused to be baptized by priests in his diocese. And he scolded those priests last year and said, how can you turn these people away when they belong to us? And here's a Pope that's going to come in and look at a situation and say, get back to basics. This is about the gospel. This is about what we are at our best. We're called to be saints. And I just said, wow. He's going to build on the beautiful teaching of Benedict, on the outreach of John Paul II, on the smile of John Paul I, and on that magnanimous heart of John the 23rd.
Now, people, you all hear what those people are saying and just say about the new Pope, right? That he's taking his name after the patron saint, Francis of Assisi, right? Now, people, did the Pope specifically say that? Or he just say Francis? I don't know. I haven't seen the full details of the media, but I don't know if he said Francis of Assisi or he just said Francis, and everybody is assuming that it's Francis of Assisi, okay? Because, people, I do not know if Pope in modern day usually pick their own name, because for them to say that this Pope is the first Pope to pick the name Francis, I'm about to disprove that, because people, Francis wasn't even a Pope. He was a preacher, a friar, a clerk, but he was not a Pope. They made him a saint. So why would this Pope pick his name if it was basically not no big timer? Because all these popes tried to emulate a Pope before them, like Pope Benedict the 16th. So now, people, I'm going to show you all how they're using the media to pull the wool over your all eyes. Okay? I'm going to show you all that this Pope did not choose the name Pope Francis in honor of Francis of Assisi, but that he chose the name Pope Francis in honor of the first Pope, Francis. Okay? People, here we have, right? I'm going to read you all a few excerpts. He said, before Cardinal Bergoglio, no Pope had ever taken the name of Saint Francis. The 16th century Spanish Jesuit priest was known for his effort to evangelize, particularly in Asia. Okay? And he say here, people, look it. And the Latin maxim, nomen est omen, which means a name is a sign. Okay, people, let me read that to you again, because you go back to the name Pope Set that I used and Set that my friend Ethiopian world used. Okay, let me read it again. Before Cardinal Bergoglio, no Pope had ever taken the name of Saint Francis, the 16th century Spanish Jesuit priest was known for his effort to evangelize, particularly in Asia. And the Latin maxim, nomen est omen, which means that a name is a sign. Okay, a name is a sign. And down here it say, the first Pope to choose the name Francis, the meaning behind miserando ad que eligendo. Pope Francis Episcopal motto in Buenos Aires, meet the new Pope. Okay, people, so now here they say it's the first Pope to choose the name Francis, okay? Whether he's saint or not, he is not the first Pope to choose the name Francis. Here's the proof. Okay, let me give you a little rundown about his history, people, okay? To make the connection, let me give you a little rundown about his history. To show you all the connections, right? But before I go there, let me show you all a little bit of his views first, because If I show you the other one first, I might get mixed up. So let me show you a little bit his views, right? And this pertains to my video, Hope Set and Ethiopian World Extension, and my video about homosexuality, okay? Let's go down to what his this is his views on homosexuality, people, okay? Look at this, his views. Bergoglio has affirmed church teaching on homosexuality, including that men and women who have deep-seated homosexual tendencies must be accepted with respect and compassion. What that means, people, that means that if you're going to accept somebody with respect and compassion, it means you have to accept everything about them, right? You have to. Because acceptance means you cannot accept someone, not the other, then you're a hypocrite. So you mean when you say accept them with respect and compassion, it means that you accept the fact that two men can have sex with each other, you gotta respect that. Or two women can have sex with each other, you have to respect that. And people, like I tell you all before, to each his own. Every man has a right to decide his own destiny. I have no quarrel with what a man wanna do. I don't have no quarrel with what two adults wanna do. But when you involve kids, that's when I really come against it. Let it chip fall with them, eh? When you want to involve children and innocent people and the church involved in it, then I'm going to fight against it. Okay, so I'm going to show you all. Okay, now, so when he said they must be accepted with respect and compassion, it means that you have to accept the fact that they don't have sex with each other. But here, people, here the double-edged sword. He opposes same-sex marriage and strongly but ultimately unsuccessfully opposed legislation introduced in 2010 to allow same-sex marriage in Argentina, calling it a real and dire anthropological throwback. That's what he said, people. Now let me show you the hypocrisy of that. People, what is the Catholic Church main teaching about sex? They teach abstinence when out of marriage, right? The church teaches it's a sin against God to have sex out of marriage. Okay? If you have sex out of marriage in the church, they want to throw you out. Okay? But yet, the new Pope, his view is that a man and a woman should not have sex unless they're married, because they sin against God. But homosexuals must be accepted with respect and compassion, but they should not be able to get married. So that means they should be able to have sex out of marriage. He opposes sex between a man and a woman, but out of marriage, but consent to it between two males. So back to the meaning of his name. Okay. Jorge Mario Bergoglio was born in Buenos Aires, Argentina, one of the five children of Italian immigrants. So you see, people, he's Italian. He's not Spanish. He's not a Spaniard. He was born in Argentina, but he's not a Spaniard. He's an Italian. Okay? Okay, his father's name was Mario Jose. I'm gonna just use the first name, Mario Jose, right? Because those are the important name. Mario Jose was his name, right, people? And his wife's name was Regina Maria. Okay, remember those names, Mario Jose and Regina Maria. Okay, what the heck is that? Sorry about that, people. So remember this name, right? Jorge Mario, which is George Mario. His surname was Mario Jose, and his mother was Regina Maria. Remember those names, okay? Remember those names. Forget about the last name, remember those names, okay? Okay. He studied and received a master's degree in chemistry at the University of Buenos Aires before he decided to pursue an ecclesiastic career. Okay? So remember that, people, he studied chemistry, okay? Remember I told you all that chemistry, that he studied alchemy, right? Alchemy. Okay? Let me show you what chemistry means. Chemistry. Chemistry, a branch of physical science, is the study of the composition, properties, and behavior of matter. Okay? Chemistry is concerned with atoms and their interaction with other atoms, and particularly with properties of chemical bond. Chemistry is also concerned with interaction between atoms, a group of atoms, and various forms of energy. Okay? Here we're going with this about controlling people's mind. Okay. For example, photochemical reaction, changes in phases of matter, separation of fixtures, properties of polymers, etc. Chemistry is sometimes called a central science because it bridges the other natural sciences like physics, geology, and biology with each other. Chemistry is a branch of physical science but distinct from physics. Okay? That etymology of the word chemistry has been much disputed. Genesis of chemistry can be traced to certain practices known as alchemy. Okay, people? So, I repeat, the etymology of the word chemistry has been much disputed. The genesis of chemistry can be traced to certain practices known as alchemy, which had been practiced for several millennia in various parts of the world, particularly the Middle East. Okay? Now, I'm going to show you the connection to the Pope and Egypt, right? The word chemistry comes from the word alchemy, an early aspect of the of practice that encompass elements of chemistry, metallurgy, philosophy, astrology, astronomy, mysticism, and medicine. It is commonly thought as the quest to turn lead or other common starting material into gold. Alchemy, which was practiced around 330, is the study of the composite of water movement, water's movement, growth, embodying, disembodying, drawing the spirits from bodies, and bonding the spirit within bodies. Okay, people? Zosimos. So you hear, people, that what alchemy is? Alchemy, which was practiced around 330, is the study of the composition of water, movement, growth, embodying, disembodying, drawing the spirits from bodies. You see where I'm going with this? And bonding the spirit within bodies. So this new Pope, people, went to study this stuff, chemistry. Okay, how to draw spirit from your body and how to bond the spirit within your bodies to trap you all in this world, to hold you all under his spell. Okay, an alchemy was called a chemist in popular speech, and later the suffix "ry" was added to this to describe the art of the chemist as chemistry. Okay, the word alchemy in turn was derived from the Arabic word alkimia. The Arabic term is borrowed from the Greek whatever. This is important, people. This may have Egyptian origin. Many believe that alchemy is derived from XN New Year, which is in turn derived from the word chemi, Akemi, which is the ancient name for Egypt. Okay, people? In Egyptian, alternatively, alchemia may be derived from Sanuia, meaning cast together. Okay? So now, people, we see now that the new Pope studied chemistry. Okay? The new Pope studied chemistry. Here he studied and received a master's degree in chemistry at the University of Buenos Aires before he decided to pursue an ecclesiastic career. So the people the plan was putting into place. Okay, this man was bred to be Pope. Okay? So he has a master's degree in alchemy. Okay? So now what that have to do with him being connected to Pope Set? Because as I told you all about, y'all have watched the videos, told you about Set and Hero. They're basically using the elements to fight each other. The elements for control and dominance of each other. Okay, so now this Pope now, he have the element, he know to control the element like Set. He represents Set because now, I'm Hero. I'm not going to be ashamed to say that. Which one of you can prove me wrong? Let him start up, let him step up and present his case and prove me wrong that I'm not Hero. So, now Pope Set have come, my uncle Set have come to fight me. Because I thwart his God taught his puppet, Pope Benedict the 16th. So now he has come. Okay, people, real quickly, right? Here's some proof, right? That Pope Francis, your new Pope, right? Is an alchemist, study alchemy. Okay? The ring of the fisherman. Okay? People, this is the ring of a fisherman, right? It's supposed to be Peter's ring. Okay, St. Peter's ring. Why? Because St. Peter was a fisherman. So they claim that this ring represents St. Peter, right? But people, that's another deception. They're not talking about St. Peter, the fisherman. Let me show you all the St. Peter we're really talking about. Okay? Now, now, people, the Peter that these people are talking about is not Peter, the fisherman. This is the Peter they're talking about, the Egyptian Peter. Peter, the netter of material creation and creativity, usually depicted holding a staff, one of the older deities of Memphis, netter of craftsmen. Craftsmen, people, Freemason, craftsmen, Freemason. Okay, this deity, along with Amen and Ra, was worshipped as an early Holy Trinity, as Amen, Ra, Peter. Peter symbolizes creativity, materialization, and metaphysics. Okay, people, so this Pope wearing the ring of Peter is not the Peter in Jesus' time. It's about the Peter of ancient Egypt. Okay? We all hear the stuff was stolen from. You doubt me? You doubt me? Here's the proof right here. The Peter they're talking about is not the Peter in the Bible, the fisherman. You doubt me? What is this? Who is this people? That's Pope Benedict, right? Standing under this statue here. What is that, people? What is that statue look like? Don't it look like the staff of Peter? Staff with yourself and wrap around it? Okay, you need more proof that this is the Peter they're speaking about? Okay. Look at Peter's friend, son. Imhotep. This symbol is a caduceus and is associated with Imhotep, son of Peter, a skilled physician who later became deified. Symbolize healing, health and wisdom. So we know that the serpent with the staff represents Peter. Okay, so if you want to talk to a fisherman, it's okay, but the one they're talking about is not the fisherman, it's this Peter. Here's the proof. Okay, so that's how we know. And what does metaphysics, right, all that have to do with alchemy, the deity of craftsmen, which is Freemason. Okay, so y'all see the proof right here. Remember, a name is a sign. A name is a sign. Peter. A name is a sign. Francis the First. Francis. Pope Francis. A name is a sign. Kemetic. Egypt. A name is a sign. Now, let me prove to you all now that this Pope didn't take his name from Pope Assisi, but take his name from Pope Francis the First, the Holy Emperor of Rome. People of Earth and all over the universe, meet Pope Francis the First, Holy Roman Emperor, King of the Romans. People, meet who you are, the Pope is emulating. Not Pope, not Francis of Assisi, but Pope Francis the First, Holy Roman Emperor, King of the Romans. Okay? Let me give you a little history. Those of you who like to listen to the news and don't like to do y'all and accept what people tell y'all and don't know y'all on research. Okay? Francis the First, Holy Roman Emperor. Francis Stephen, 8 December 1708, 18 August 1765, was Holy Roman Emperor and Grand Duke of Tuscany. Okay, though his wife effectively executed the real powers of those positions, with his wife, Maria Theresa, he was the founder of the Habsburg-Lorraine dynasty. Now people, I'm going to prove to you all now that your new Pope, Pope Francis, who claimed to be Pope Francis the First, is emulating the real Pope Francis, Holy Roman Emperor, King of the Romans. I'm going to show you, I remember I told you all about the names, right? That his father's name was Mario Jose, right? And Mario is for Maria, okay, and Jose is for Joseph, so Joseph Maria, so he's carrying his mother's name, and Mario, okay, y'all know the Spanish do it, right, and his mother's name is Regina Maria, Queen Maria, right, okay, I'm gonna show you all this, I'm gonna show you all the direct parallel between the lives of these two men, people. Remember I told you all the first guy was a Freemason, right? And he studied alchemy, right? So did Francis the First. Same exact thing. Watch this. Francis was born in Nancy, Lorraine, now in France, the oldest surviving son of Leopold Joseph. Okay? So you see people, you see the name Joseph repeating itself? The new Pope, father name was Joseph. Mario Jose. Okay. And this one here name is Leopold Jose or Leopold Joseph. So Mario Joseph, Leopold Joseph. Okay, was his father, right? Okay. And his wife, Elizabeth Charlotte. Okay, the mother name don't fit there yet. I'm gonna show you how the mother name fit. Let me go down. Francis' wife name was Maria Theresa. And remember, the new Pope, his mother name, Regina Maria. gay Queen Maria. And this Maria was a queen also. So you see, Maria Theresa and Francis I had 16 children. The youngest daughter was a future queen consort of France, Marie Antoinette. So you see the name, people? Queen means Regina. Reina, Regina, queen. Same thing, Reina, Regina is queen. Okay? So, just a play on the words and the letters, but it's the same thing. So you see here? So you see the collection, people? How this man's life have paralleled the life of Francis I, Holy Emperor of Rome, King of the Romans. Huh, people? Do you all see? Okay, let me see y'all some more. Okay. Titles. Francis I, by the grace of God, elected Holy Roman Emperor forever, August, King in Germany and of Jerusalem, Archduke of Austria, Duke of Lorraine, Bar, and Grand Duke of Tuscany, Duke of Calabria, in Silesia of Teschen, Prince of Charlesville, Margrave of Pont-a-Mousson and Nomeny, Count of Provence, Vaudemont, Blamont, Zuffen, Sauerden, Salm, Falkenstein, etc., etc. So you see the title here, people. Francis I, by the grace of God, elected Holy Roman Emperor forever, August King in Germany, okay? So now, you are new Pope now. Is the new Pope. He's the first and he's the last. Forever, because with him, Babylon gonna fall, okay? So now, people, you all see. You all see, people, that this Pope, your new Pope, does not emulate Francis of Assisi, but Francis I, the Holy Roman Emperor, okay? And let's see if we see any coat of arms. I don't see any coat of arms. I would like to see his coat of arms, because I'm sure they're very similar. I'm going to search, see if I find the coat of arms, people, okay? Bear with me a minute. I'll be right back. Okay, people, I found the... This is the coat of arms, right? For Pope Francis I, right? This is coat of arms. Shall I give you a close-up shot of it? Okay. This is coat of arms. See, let's call it the eagle, bird on top of the crown on its head, right? We have that bird with the crown on its head. We have another image here with a crown. The bird is standing on the crown, right? So he's standing on another king or whatever. And you see the leaves curl over like arms, right? And then at the bottom we have the shield. Then we have like other birds, eagle, whatever you want to call them. Three of them inside, 1, 2, 3, right? You see that, people? Now compare to the one of your new Pope. You see a Pope Francis I. Compare to the coat of arms of your new Pope, okay? Let's go. Okay, over here is the coat of arms of your new Pope. You see, I'm gonna enlarge it, but look, you see the hat on top like a crown, sitting on top of another, like a cross, a double cross. Let's enlarge it. Okay. We don't have the eagle, right? But I'm gonna show you the eagle right now. Have the variation, right? Okay, you see the hat on top, there's a crown, right? It's sitting over something, like a cross with two arms, right? And in the middle is the sun, which represents What? Okay, first, right, we have the coat of arm. We have the rope, right? Rope curving around like trees, right? Like leaves, right? I'm gonna put them together to show you all the similarities, right? You see how the arm come over? You see how the ropes come over like arms? How the tree leaves come over like arms? And then here we have grapes, right? A bunch of grapes, right? Okay. Grapes don't grow on ropes. They grow on and leaves, right? Vines, right? So we see what it means. The ropes pull them mean vines. Then in here we have the star, which are the eagles, are the birds. Then we have the sun. The eagle are the birds. We got one, two, three, whatever those things are, right? So let me put them side by side to show you all the similarities. So yeah, I can see people that this vine, these leaves, right? And this Francis the First and his coat of arms, right? And you see the eagle or the phoenix, which represent the sun, right? And we see three of them inside, we represent star, right? And we see grapes. And in this one we see leaves. People, these people are tricky. They deal with alchemy, which means they can shape-shift stuff. But they have the same meaning. So all this guy did was change the emblem and his thing, but it's the same thing. Okay, we have a crown on the top. Okay? Which represent the hat. We have the phoenix with his arm outstretched. Which represent this cross here with the two, with the double arms. Same thing. Then we have it sun and the sun, which is a crown. The sun is also a crown, king. Same thing. Then we have the shield. We have the grapes and the star, which also represent phoenix. So you see people? Okay. Pope Francis I also ruled Austria and Mexico. Okay? So he was also in America. So therefore, Pope Francis is not the first Latin Pope. Because his Pope also, even though he wasn't from Mexico, he was Pope of Mexico also. Okay? He ruled Mexico also. Okay. So now we see the similarities now. Now, let me show you some more similarities between these two popes to drive home the point. Now people, remember I said it, right? They said that this pope, right, had power, but he let his power go, he forgo on it because he didn't really like that spotlight, right? Let me show you all that it's the same thing that Pope Francis I did. Exactly what this Pope did. Look, listen to this first.
Jorge Mario Bergoglio is an Argentine-born son of Italian immigrants, one of five children. He lost a lung to an infection when he was a teenager, but went on to become a priest in 1969. He joined the Jesuit order, embracing an austere lifestyle. Even as a cardinal and archbishop of Buenos Aires, he shunned the privileges and trappings that usually come with the job.
He took the tram to work. He lived in a small apartment rather than in the Archbishop's palace. He's not a man of a lot of fuss, pomp, and circumstances.
In 2005, Bergoglio was runner-up behind Joseph Ratzinger to replace the late Pope John Paul II. He is regarded as a strong defender of Catholic doctrine.
Argentina.
Y a todo el mundo.
Tonight, choosing to become Pope Francis, he takes the name of 13th century preacher St. Francis Assisi, who lived a life of poverty. No surprise to those who know him.
You can see the humility of the man. You can see the calm of the man. And I can tell you, I know the strength of the man and the compassion of the man.
His election has sparked excitement in Latin America.
So people, do you all see how the media tried to mislead you all and tell you all that this guy is trying to emulate the preacher Francis Assisi? Now let me dispel that once and for all. Let me show you all that Pope Francis the First, Holy Emperor of Rome, King of the Romans, did the same thing that this Pope did. He shunned power. He shunned wealth. Here's the proof, people. Here's the undeniable proof that this Pope here is deceiving you all. Pope Seth. So people, remember all those do-gooder things that they say the new Pope did? How he shunned power and wealth and all that stuff? Pope Francis the First, Holy Emperor of Rome, King of the Romans, did the same thing. Look here. Francis was well content to leave the wielding of power to his able wife. He had a natural fund of good sense and some business capacity and was a useful assistant to Maria Theresa in the laborious task of governing the complicated Austrian dominions. But his function appeared to be primarily secretarial. He also took a great interest in the natural sciences, like chemistry. He was a member of the Freemason. Okay, people? So this man also shunned power. He shunned all the stuff. He would prefer going out, hanging with people, chasing after girls. And he liked natural science. So he had no interest in wealth. He gave it all to, he had no interest in wealth and power. Okay, he was more interested in science. So you all see, people, Francis the First, by the grace of God, elected Holy Roman Emperor, forever August King in Germany and Jerusalem. Forever, people, okay? Elected Holy Roman Emperor, elect of God, was also a chemist. Okay? He studied alchemy. He was well content to leave the willing of power to his wife. He had a natural fund of good sense and some business capacity. Okay? He also took a great interest in the natural sciences. He was a member of the Freemason. So people, who else took a great interest in the natural sciences? Who else? Your new Pope. And where did the word chemistry come from? Egypt, right? You mean chemi, chemet, chemetic chart, Egypt. What have I been showing you all, people? What have Palmer been showing you all in the video that I just uploaded about the Pope set? Didn't I show you all these figures from the chemetic chart, people? Okay, and what did they say here? What do they say here, people? What do they say here? Before Cardinal Bergoglio, no Pope had ever taken the name of Saint Francis, the 16th century Spanish Jesuit, priest known for his effort to evangelize, particularly in Asia. And the Latin maxim, nomen est omen, which means that a name is a sign. So you see, people, a name is a sign. A name is a sign. Chemetic, chemistry. Okay? Pope Francis, Freemason, alchemy, chemistry. It's all a sign. And I showed you all the chemical charts and tell you all that this Pope going to represent Pope Seth. How much more proof do you all need, people? A name is a sign. Pope Francis the First, he's not taking on the name of Pope Francis, Francis of Assisi. He was not a Pope. He's taking on the name of Francis the First, Holy Roman Emperor, King of the Romans. Okay? That's who name he's taking on. That's who he's emulating. Behold your new Pope, reincarnated. If his mother and his father's name and his wife's name, they all match. Okay? How much more proof y'all need, people? Y'all Holy Roman Emperor have risen. King of the Romans have risen. How much more proof y'all need, people? Y'all Holy Roman Emperor have risen. The King of the Romans have risen. Francis the First. They're lying to you all. How much more proof y'all need, people? All right. Here's some more.
We got word today that scientists believe they have now confirmed the discovery of the so-called God particle. Physicists have long theorized that there is a subatomic building block that exists that must give mass to everything in the universe, hence the nickname. But they had never seen the particle called the Higgs boson. Last summer, they announced the world's largest atom smasher may have found the first evidence that it exists, and now they are saying new evidence strongly indicates that they found it. Probably a Nobel Prize in that.